As if we didn't have enough breaking news today with the drop of the Final Cut Pro for iPad app, the Final Cut Mac app did get a little update as well. Today I'm going to tell you everything that's new in version 10.6.6. The first thing you need to know is that you need to be on Monterey 12.6 to use this version of Final Cut. Let's jump right into what's new. The first new and exciting thing starts right in the Final Cut Pro for iPad app. I can share my iPad projects to the Mac version. Just hit the share button, hit Final Cut Pro for iPad project. You're going to want to include all of the media most likely, and I'm just going to airdrop this guy to myself. Now here in my downloads folder, I get this Final Cut project. I could just right click, select open with, and open it in Final Cut Pro. It's going to ask me where I want to save this library, and then it's going to import all of the media, and now you can edit your iPad projects right on Final Cut Pro on the Mac. The second new update also relates to the Final Cut Pro for iPad app, which is that you can manipulate the timing of live drawings from the app here in your projects in Final Cut Pro. So here's like a scribble transition I made with the live drawing feature in Final Cut. If I wanted to modify the timing of this guy, I just select it and head on over to the generators inspector and use the slider to speed up or slow down that motion. Another new thing in 10.6.6 is finally we get new titles and transitions and backgrounds in Final Cut Pro. You can find them under the dynamic category. These are all of the titles, and of course, all of these colors and things are customizable. You also get these dynamic backgrounds. And we got some new dynamic transitions here that coordinate with the dynamic titles as well. Another new update that has everybody buzzing is the Scene Background Remover. You can find this in your effects browser under Masks and Keying. Final Cut does tell us that this effect works best when you have a shot where your subject walks in or out of the frame. So it's a little bit different from Keeper, which I reviewed on my favorite plugins video. If you haven't seen that, I'll link to it right here and down below. But when I first heard about this feature, I thought, oh, RIP Keeper, you know, that's too bad that Final Cut came up with a competing effect. However, I do think the Keeper one works a little bit differently. What do you guys think about a video where I do a side-by-side between third-party plugins and features that are native to Final Cut and see which one works better? I think you guys would like that video. I think that video is going to be coming up really soon. All right, let's talk about the next thing that's new in 10.6.6, which is these color board presets. These color board presets just apply a color board to your clip with adjustments already made. The one you're looking at here is called Warm. Here's the before, here's the after. Speaking of the color board, there's a new color correction tool in Final Cut Pro 10.6.6, creatively called Color Adjustments. In the Color Inspector, drop down your Corrections menu and select Color Adjustments. Now you can use a slider to adjust your colors. And what's nice is you can either warm up or cool down your highlights, shadows, or midtones independently. You can also adjust the tint of all of those things independently as well. Another update is that the green screen and Luma keyers are now optimized for HDR video. And speaking of HDR video, the timelines have automatic color management now, which means that when you drop an HDR video clip onto an SDR timeline, it used to look like this, right? It would get so blown out. People would get so panicked and confused. Now with 10.6.6, when you drop an HDR clip onto an SDR timeline or an SDR clip to an HDR timeline, they will all look great and play nicely together. We love that update. Another update has to do with RAW video files. You can install a ProRes RAW plugin from your camera's manufacturer to view and adjust ProRes RAW camera settings optimized for that manufacturer's camera sensors. So you just need to download the plugin from your manufacturer, import that raw media, and in the Info Inspector, scroll to the bottom and click Modify to ProRes RAW Settings. And in the ProRes RAW Settings window, just click the Process Using pop-up menu and choose the right plugin you want to use depending on your raw media. And the last update is that we got a few new audio effects from Logic. The first one here is called Chromaverb. It has a lot of presets to choose from. Let's make it sound like I'm in a really big room instead of my tiny office. The next one is called Vintage Tube. This one also has a lot of presets. I personally like the lo-fi speaker.
Makes you sound like you're on like an old radio.
We also got an update to the de-esser effect, de-esser 2. It should make your speakers sound simply stupendous. You guys, that's what's new in 10.6.6. What are you most excited about? Let me know in the comments. Picked out some other videos. See you again.